It's Jackson Snyder Presents time.
Starring Bogdan G. Shrumkov,
the Thinking Believer.
Shine, oh
I saw a post a friend shared. I've read it and find it worthy of your reading. Do I agree with everything said? Not fully. Do I think many of the questions asked need answers? Absolutely. I watched as local agencies geared up for an event that never met its billing. Places where predictions of 1,500 to 3,000 deaths by May ended up being a total of 6. I watched facilities make ready for the surge of patients to help with overflowing hospitals. Those hospitals, in most places, are running less than half of their normal patient load. Entire floors are shut down, and now staff are enduring their hours cut. Those emergency facilities are now being dismantled, and I'm seeing a division of people, some that now live in total fear, and those that are scratching their heads wondering why their job is gone, their bank accounts empty, and getting angry knowing that government workers are getting their full paycheck and not having to follow all the rules. The 500,000 to 2 million deaths never happened, and that was the number with all the restrictions. So, as I read on, consider, why not question everything? And here I put my own comment in, because nobody will give you or can give you an answer. Those that know won't say a thing about it. The rest don't know any better than you do. Now I continue. Why can you go to Walmart but not Kohl's? Why the dollar store and not a mom and pop shop? Why can't you have an elective surgery but you can have an abortion, which is elective? Why should you stay inside yet heat and sunlight kill the virus? Why can't kids who are not at risk play on an outdoor playground where the sun kills the virus? Why don't people know that these are recommendations and not laws? A law goes through due process. Why is it okay for government officials to get a haircut, but not common citizens? Why the fear when this virus has a less than 1% death rate, and with more testing is going even lower with each passing week? Why have coroners question death certificates listed as CV-19? Why are areas like Chicago and New York gearing up for mass vaccination? What makes one person essential and another not? Does not shelter at home mean there is a whole population of people not staying home so we can? Why are they dividing us? How do people not know that we are a republic and not a democracy? Where has the flu gone? Why are they telling us to mask up after 2 months of lockdown? Why is the CDC saying kids need to be masked when they return to school or attend church when they know that masks restrict oxygen? What is this oppression and loss of liberty doing to the mental health of our kids and to our mental health? Why have most other death rates magically dropped since the virus? Why did world leaders meet in China in October of 2019? Why are the common people being controlled by the government and no one is controlling the government? Why are hospitals paid more for COVID-19 deaths? Why are some doctors speaking out and then getting silenced? Why did Obama give the Wuhan lab $334 million? What does a computer geek have to do with a pandemic? And why does he want 7 billion coronaviruses vaccines? Why Agenda 2020, Agenda 21, and 2030? Why did the CDC have a job posting for pandemic relief workers in November of 2019? Why did Dr. Fauci say in 2017 that the Trump administration would be faced with a surprise pandemic? And then he runs the pandemic team. Why are they infringing on Christian religious freedoms, but in many places, Islam appears exempt from many of the same restrictions? Why can many people shop at Menards, Lowe's, or Home Depot, but we're not allowed to go into our church buildings? Why will 30% to 50% of small local businesses end up bankrupt and gone? I don't care if you're a Republican or a Democrat or of a third party. If you're not asking these questions, you really should. the poster ads. Most local governments did what they did based on the official information given to them and acted accordingly. Many state governments did the same. However, some state governments, that is governors, have become drunk with power and hang continued restrictions over the heads of those that dare question anything, like the sword of Damocles. Much of what I'm seeing doesn't pass the smell test. Your thoughts? One person commented, I've seen the same scenario play out here in Virginia. There are too many questions that remain unanswered. For sure, the virus is real. However, questions still abound of how, when, and where it came from. Now there's a run on meat in the stores. But for me and my house, I believe when the Lord says, fear not. And another poster says, yet many people still have the attitude that they can easily catch COVID and die from it. But I also think the silent majority believes otherwise. That silent majority better vote when they have the opportunity. And someone answers this, let's be honest, the Senate is in session, but the House is not. They want this to close down America through the election. That's a very good, thought-provoking post here on Facebook. I heard yesterday that a haircutting salon in Texas, I believe, refused to shut the doors down when they were told to by the authorities. They were given a citation, at least one. They're expecting another citation as well. Then what's next? Do the authorities come down and close them out? This particular salon had, if I remember right, 19 operators, plus the proprietor, that's 20 people in that particular place, all out of work, all unable to pay their mortgages, all unable to go any place in an area in which this particular genus of flu is not even threatening. And when I go to a grocery, there are very few people there, and those that are there are wearing masks. And it appears to me, when I just pass these people, they turn their head away as if my passing them in a grocery is going to give them a fatal disease. This is getting ridiculous. It is political. It was premeditated. In that very comment that I just read, the poster did talk about certain parties being ready for this long before we even knew about it. In one particular case, a year before, and that person was Dr. Fauci. He has the answers, but he's not telling. How convenient this is for certain parties that have not shown themselves as being in any kind of lockdown, but has been out socializing in big crowds, while at the same time telling you to stay home. Why? More questions.
Does that mean we're going to do questions and answers today on the show?
Well, I hadn't planned anything, had you? Why don't we do questions and answers today? But the questions and answers had to be a little more benign than these, because we just don't have the answers.
But what we do is we give Bible answers to particular questions. And I know in your last message on COVID-19, you said what we must do is go back to trusting the Creator and His beloved Son, instead of going off willy-nilly in fear, and that trusting was older than any Bible, was there before there was a sermon, that we trust Yahweh, and we call on the presence of His Son to protect us and to give us truth in this matter, because we're not getting truth, we don't know who to ask, and when we ask some that should know, we don't get answer anyway.
All right, brother, if you will present the questions, I can try the answers.
Do you want me to make sure that these questions were really asked of you and this is not a setup?
Sure, I don't set anything up like that. That would make me just as dishonest as these conspirators who are keeping the reasons for this epidemic out of the public. It is ridiculous.
Oh, it is ridiculous, but it's working to someone's advantage, that is for sure. But we could go into this all day, and the politics of it, and who might be winners and who might be losers. Suffice it to say, this is the greatest hoax with the greatest result, and most people believing it, than any other in the history of world.
Absolutely. I just came back from the liquor store, where I bought some communion wine. And you know what I saw in that store? I saw five Baptists dancing around the aisles. No other time in history are you going to see five Baptists in a liquor store unless at least two of them are dancing.
Oh, no. You think that's funny? Well, I'll tell you one thing. Even the Pentecostals are dancing in the liquor store and every place else now because all them churches are there closed. Where else would they be dancing?
Actually, brother, that was uncalled for. There's absolutely no use denigrating Pentecostals in this time of trouble.
Oh, I see your point.
I must say that is quite interesting.
Do you concur?
I concur.
I concur.
I concur.
I concur.
I concur.
Concur.
I concur.
Affirmative. Keep this under your hat until an announcement is made.
You have been listening to Jackson Snyder Presents on Hebrew Nation Radio.